So again, we are resuming with plasmid. So plasmid is used as a vector in the field of genetic engineering. Okay, so different medicines or different diseases which were not curable in the ancient period of time, nowadays it is curable and the medicine is available in large quantity in the different fields. So the reason behind it is the genetic engineering. So for example, insulin, and due to the deficiency of insulin, what happens? There is diabetes. Okay, there are two types of diabetes: diabetes mellitus and diabetes insipidus. So diabetes mellitus is due to the deficiency of insulin hormone secreted in the human individual. So if any human who is not having this diabetes, the genes from that individual will be taken and a bacterial cell will be chosen, and in that bacterial cell, with the help of restriction endonuclease, a part of plasmid is removed and the gene responsible for the synthesis of insulin is added with the help of DNA ligase. Now this plasmid is having the genes for the synthesis of insulin hormone. Okay, now this bacteria, you know that the rate of reproduction of bacteria is very, very high. So multiple copies of bacteria will be formed having the genes for the synthesis of insulin, and in that respect only in the culture medium enough amount of insulin will be secreted, and this insulin can be collected and used for the patients who are suffering from diabetes mellitus. So this is how, with the help of genetic engineering, the humulin was synthesized in the laboratory, and nowadays this diabetes mellitus is not a deadly disease. So this is how the plasmid is very useful for the field of genetic engineering, because the plasmid do not has to take part in the bacterial cell division and its control and regulation. So this is extra chromosomal DNA. So this extra chromosomal DNA is used as a vector in the field of genetic engineering. Then flagella is a whip-like structure, extension of cytoplasm, which pierces out through the cell wall and capsule. And by the whipping and lashing movement of the flagella helps the bacteria to move from one place to another place. So this is all for today. Thank you, everyone.